cows hopped in the bed with us just the other night. It crawled right up the missus' leg and gave us such a fright. Then she sprang into me arms and I thought I'd do all right. But it bit me on the you-know-what, now I'm a sorry sight. I had to pay a visit to the doctor the next day. Infection started stirring and I knew I wasn't gay. He stuck a great big needle in and bandaged me up tight. That mouse committed mortal sin in our double bed that night. I'd like to catch that rascal, but all mice look the same, and I wouldn't know which one of them on which to lay the blame. But I'd like to wreck his future, like he nearly did to me, and I've devised a little plan as fiendish as can be. I got myself a little board, it wasn't hard to make, with a razor blade on top of it and a piece of cheese for bait. I'll put it there outside his hole and then sit back and gloat, 'cause when he reaches for the cheese, he'll cut his flaming throat. So be careful all you fellas, if a mouse plague comes along, you never know where they'll appear or what they'll feed upon. Just when you think they've disappeared, one'll turn up where it shouldn't. And the moral of this story is, if one did, you probably couldn't. The mice are getting desperate when they're crawling to your bed, and what that blighter did to me is better left unsaid. But don't forget my warning, no matter what you do, 'cause if they'll bite a little bloke like me, what would they do to you? Yes, if they'll bite a little bloke like me, what would they do to you?